Welcome to another hands-on lesson. In this one, we're going to create a serverless and event-driven application. So how does it look? Okay, so we're going to be a user. We're going to submit a notification to an SNS topic. When we do that, it's going to be integrated with a queue. In other words, the queue is subscribed to the topic, and the message that we add to the topic ends up in the queue. Then SQS is going to trigger a Lambda function. That function is going to run, and it's going to write some information to CloudWatch. And whatever we put in the topic, we're going to see that in CloudWatch logs. So that's it. Quite simple, and it's event-driven and serverless. So in the console, I have Amazon SQS, SNS, and Lambda open. The first thing I'm going to do is create my queue. It's going to be a standard queue, and I will simply call it my queue. Now, I'm not going to change any of these parameters here. We're just going to leave the configuration as it is, scroll down, and we're going to create our queue. Next, we're going to go to SNS. In SNS, we're going to create a topic. So you can go over to topics on the left-hand side, create a topic, choose standard, and I'll simply call it my topic. Then I can simply go down, don't need to change anything else, and just create the SNS topic. There's now an option to create a subscription. So let's do that. And the topic ARN is selected for us. Then I'm going to choose Amazon SQS for the protocol and select my queue as the endpoint. And then I simply need to create the subscription. Now that's great, but actually SNS does need permissions to the queue. So what we can do is copy the ARN of our topic. So sorry, not this one here, not the subscription, go up to the topic, copy the ARN, and then let's go to Visual Studio Code. So I have an access policy here. What I need to do is copy my source ARN for my topic in here. So that's my topic. Now I need to go back and get the queue ARN. So in SQS, let's simply copy the queue ARN. So not the URL, make sure it's the ARN. And back in the file here, I'm simply going to paste this in. So what does this do? It allows the service sns.amazonaws.com to send a message to the queue. And we've specified the source ARN of the topic. So we copy this information and we're going to put it in as an access policy on SQS. On SQS, let's go to access policy and we'll click on edit. So this is an example of a resource-based policy. Now I'm going to delete out everything that's already in there and paste in my code and then click on save. And that's the resource policy updated. So now SNS does have permissions to the SQS queue. Next, we need to update our function code. So we already have a function. Let's come into the function and in source code, let's go to index.js. And again, we've got some code in Visual Studio. So I've opened this file in the AWS Lambda directory, SQS to Lambda. Copy all of the code to your clipboards and let's go and paste it in. We'll simply paste it into the code editor and then deploy. This Lambda function code is going to pass the messages from SQS and it's going to write whatever it finds in the body of the message into CloudWatch logs. Now there's just one more thing we need to do. So we do need to have some permissions to the queue for Lambda as well. Remember, the function execution role is what determines the permissions that Lambda has when it executes. So it must have permissions to read messages from the queue and then delete them from the queue. So back in Lambda, let's go to configuration and then choose the execution role. Then I'm going to click on add permissions and attach policies. Let's just search for SQS. And what we want is the SQS execution role. This does have the receive message and delete message permissions. So we'll attach that policy to the role. Lastly, we're going to create the trigger in SQS. So we go to Lambda triggers, configure Lambda function trigger, choose the Lambda function, and then click on save. And that shouldn't take long. It says a minute, but it's usually very, very quick. There we go. That is now enabled. All right. So what have we done? Well, we've created an SNS topic and we've subscribed an SQS queue to the topic. And we made sure that the queue has permissions to allow the topic to add messages to the queue. Then we updated the function code and we added permissions to receive messages and delete them from the queue. And of course, it already has permissions to CloudWatch. So when we add a message to the topic, and we'll do that manually, it will then push that message to the queue. Lambda will then process it and write the event to CloudWatch. So let's get this going. What we're going to do is on our topic, click on publish message, and we're going to enter a subject. I just wrote serverless app test, and then I'm going to put yay, it worked. All right, so let's just click on publish and hopefully it really will work. So that really shouldn't take very long. What we're going to do is go to Lambda and then go back to monitor, click on view logs in CloudWatch logs. We can see a very recent execution happened. I know that this is the most recent one. And what I do here is just expand each of these and we can see the information. Here we can see the subject and we can see the message which I added manually. So that's it, a really simple serverless application that is event driven. Now with serverless, these things don't really cost much money, but you might want to delete your queue. There is a free tier and you're very unlikely to spend any money on this, but I'm just going to go and delete my queue anyway. For Lambda, you only ever pay when it's executed and there's a huge free tier. So it's not going to cost you anything, but again, super simple to delete once you've finished with it. So I'll just go ahead and delete my function. And then lastly, you can very simply delete your topic. Topics and subscriptions are two different things. So you might want to delete the topic first and then go ahead and delete the subscription. And that's it then. We're all cleaned up.